I always said that I would never say I told you so, but if I were ever going to do that, it would likely be about vitamin D. I started my company 38 years ago. Even in my multivitamins 38 years ago, when the RDA was 200 or 400 IU, we offered 1,000 IU. 1,000 IU was our minimum level of vitamin D. Why? Because of the science, because it was already clear at that point in time that the levels of vitamin D in the American population were deficient or insufficient. There is no adequate dietary source of vitamin D. Our only opportunity to produce vitamin D is from sunlight. And as we get older, we do that very poorly and very inefficiently. Moreover, we're not in the sun that much. Plus, we add sunscreen to the equation, so we really do not have an opportunity to produce adequate amounts of vitamin D. Even if you use the levels, the blood levels that are established in the medical community for what's a healthy vitamin D level, which I think are about half as high as they should be. But even if you use those minimal levels, and you look at folks who are not supplementing vitamin D in this country, depending on the research, you'll be between 80 to 100%. And I believe if you're not supplementing, it's pretty close to 100% of the population is deficient or insufficient in vitamin D. So it's something I've spoken about for 38 years. If you've used my products, even just one of my multivitamins, you are already getting a good amount of vitamin D. But it's now clear that 1,000 to 2,000 IU, that really is just the starting point, that the proper level to supplement is more like 2,000 to 4,000 IU daily. And if we're overweight, which the majority of Americans are overweight or obese, because vitamin D is unfortunately sequestered, trapped in body fat, it means that you have to supplement even more vitamin D to achieve the same blood level. Again, because that vitamin D gets trapped in your body fat. So, yet another benefit for being at a more optimum weight is that it's easier and more, it's going to be more common that you're going to have a healthy vitamin D level. So, it does, I think, enhance the credibility of my company. That's something today that has become such a buzzword, such a watchword, and we hear constant talk about an epidemic of vitamin D deficiency, a pandemic worldwide of vitamin D insufficiency that we have been talking about. I personally have been talking about it for 38 years. You could watch my shows on television from almost 30 years ago and hear me speak to this. So it is incredibly important. I'm often asked what's the single most important nutrient anyone can supplement. I would say vitamin D. Probably a good idea to get it in a multivitamin because then you get B12 as well in a proper form and all the B complex and vitamin C, as you do say with our multivitamins. But vitamin D, because of the role in our body, the multitude of roles it plays in our body, it's not just a vitamin, it actually functions a bit like a hormone. So vitamin D just plays so many different roles, whether it's in our nervous system, cardiovascular system, it's the list goes on and on and on, that we don't want to move through life having suboptimal, having inadequate levels of vitamin D. So again, vitamin D3 is the proper form, but once again, it's something that we really need to focus on, we really must be aware of, and as I've been saying for a few decades, when you're at your doctor's office and you find out your cholesterol level, your blood sugar level, and all those important things like blood pressure and all the things that are a direct impact on the, or a direct indication of our health, we also must know our vitamin D levels. And as I often say, it should be above 50, and it should be between 60 and 80 ideally.